Hey Trade Pros, it's Victor from TradePro Academy, and today we've got another special video for you today. And we're going to be discussing the three tips or three tricks that will take you from a more amateur inconsistent trader to a full-time futures trader, a full-time professional futures trader. So these are three very simple things that everyone probably knows, but might not be diligent enough to adhere to, or may not be willing to put in that time and effort. But these three simple little things, whether you take one, three, or just two of them, will really change your futures trading career. Now let's go through these three little tricks or tips that differentiate the full-time futures trader and the amateur futures trader. Now, a lot of you may be thinking, what's the difference between a full-time futures trader, one that consistently makes an income, versus those stragglers that are finding it a little more hard to get to that level of consistency, to get to that full-time level? And I'm gonna tell you right now, it's not capital and it's not ability, because we believe that anyone can learn how to trade futures. It really takes diligence, patience, and perseverance to really get to that full-time level at which you're continuously making money in the futures market and taking money out to support yourself. Now, the first tip here is pretty obvious, but it's what you do outside of the futures market that really determines who you are as a futures trader and how you will do. Now, a lot of people think that you gotta sit in front of the computer 24 hours a day, because futures markets are pretty much open 24 hours a day, and just trade all the time without really doing anything to improve yourself after the fact. To build that level of professionalism, you have to do the things outside of those futures hours. Now, trading should only be a small portion of your time, and a large portion should be what you do outside of that to improve yourself. Now, the futures markets can teach you how to trade futures, and they're the best teacher out there. However, we like to divide our time between 15 to 25% actually trading and 75 to 85% doing the other stuff, the stuff that no one really wants to do. Now, what does that other stuff include? Review is the biggest thing. What do you do after you're done your trading day? You better be sitting down and reviewing your trades, your strategy, your setups, and analyzing the market. What happened? Did I react to it? Did I not react to it? Why? How will I improve from this? Now, the successful futures trader takes that time away from the market, 75 to 85% time, and really goes through and setting up his strategy, his plan, criteria, and the next best trade. A lot of analysis should be done at this point to improve yourself for the next day and review what you've done for the current day. Now, a common misconception is that you have to be in the futures markets or in any market 100% of the time to get those profits. Now, that's not really the case. That's why we advocate the 2 hours a day of futures trading to make that daily goal, that income goal. Because at that point, those 2 hours, that's when your mental capital is at its sharpest, and that's when all the opportunity flows in between the US session and the European close, 9:30 to about 11:30 a.m. Eastern time. Like I said, that professional full-time futures trader doesn't really only learn from the market, but he learns from himself in that review. Now, your time is best spent thinking of a strategy, a plan, and how you're gonna execute it come the next trade. That's the next best trade. Sticking to that and living by that and creating that in the 80-ish percent time you have outside of the futures market will propel you to that one level of consistency that you really need. I almost guarantee that you'll see an instantaneous shift in your futures trading. I can really tell you for a fact that you will see a very large shift in your futures trading and a large improvement if you just take this one rule and run with it. What are you gonna do when you're not in the futures markets? When you sit in front of the computer all day and you're looking for opportunity 100% of the time when the markets are open, you're gonna catch yourself doing things that you honestly wouldn't be doing otherwise if you really stuck that plan, because your mental capital is exhausted. You start to look for trades that aren't there, and you start making trades up, and that's how you blow accounts, and that's how you negate the consistency that you need to become a full-time trader. Now, we advocate those 2 hours that I mentioned before because they're the most opportunistic, and that's when your mental capital is the sharpest. Pick any 2 hours of the day where there's a lot of volume, a lot of volatility, and just spend that time trading and the rest of your time reviewing, analyzing, coming up with a trading strategy, coming up with a plan, and just implementing it. And every day review it. Did I follow my plan? How am I gonna follow my plan tomorrow if I did not? What do I need to do to remain diligent and consistent? Now, tip number two is you gotta get back to basics. If you're a beginner, that's great, this is where you start off. Or if you've been struggling in the past to find consistency, get back to basics. What are basics? Market structure and price action. Before you jump into all the futures order flow tools, be able to read markets first. Know what the trend is, know what the market structure is. What are you looking to do? Is this a long market structure or is it a short market structure? Are you buying dips or are you selling the rip? Now, this is the basic of everything. You need to know how to read the patterns and read the movements before you start implementing other tools. Also, I really advocate getting rid of all those indicators, moving averages, MACDs, whatever it may be. Just get rid of the indicators, go back to the basics, use volume. That's the number one thing you'll need, volume and just reading price action. That's how you're gonna really get to that level and see a really large shift in your futures trading. The basics are where consistent traders are made, and then you start adding order flow tools. Still not advocating indicators, order flow tools to read volume better and actual contracts traded. Also the interest of trades in the inventory in the Dom ladder, the level two. Now to add to this, I really advocate sticking to the basics by just taking one trading strategy, sticking to it, and find the consistency in that. There's no need to make up trades, looking for breakouts, fades, pullbacks, whatever it is, combining all three together just to make something up that's not really there. Pick one strategy that really makes sense to you, that really adheres to your trading, and just stick to it. For example, the pullback strategy. All I do is trade pullback strategies. I'm not really looking for breakouts, only if the time is right and there's volatility. But I've been trading for some years now. I really advocate the pullback strategy. It's the cleanest, the highest probability, and you can really narrow down the next best trade there. Once you find one strategy that works for you, build the consistency on that strategy. There's no need to feel that you're missing out on other things, because when you're patient and when you're not in the market 100% of the time, when you've got five trades, five bullets to fire throughout the day, you really see the best opportunities, because that's what you're looking for. You're looking for the next best trade. Talk it out to yourself. What am I looking for if this happens? If this happens, how am I acting? If this happens, if this happens. Again, comes back to point number one. It's all in that plan of yours. Now follow that plan. The final tip I have for you is to reinvest in yourself and reinvest in your account. Now, what does that mean? First thing, a mentor. No matter how great you are, no matter what you do, you always need a mentor. Everyone has a mentor. I have a mentor. And there's always someone that knows more than you. Just getting a little advice or a few tricks from them will really propel your futures trading. Someone who's done it consistently, someone who's done it professionally, can help you get to that level. What they're going to tell you is what I'm telling you in this video. Stick to basics and do things outside of trading that really help you improve your trading. Now, to build on that, to reinvest in yourself and your account, you've got to be consistent. Now, taking those home run huge positions and waiting for that large move will make your account just roller coaster back and forth. You'll be taking larger losses, larger wins inconsistently. A tip for you is take those smaller wins consecutively. Take small wins at the beginning and build that account, and don't flush it out after you've seen a large profit. Keep enough in there so you have margin and then some. Now, starting with a $100 win every day can easily turn into a $1,000 win every day by scaling up a contract size and earning that right. You have to earn the right to trade big. Doesn't mean because for 1 week you've consistently made $100, you start hitting $300, $400, $500. But the gap between making $100 a day and $1,000 a day is really small in futures trading. You just need to build that consistency, build that confidence, and really develop your abilities as a trader. And by abilities, I mean your mental capital and your mindset. By gaining consistent small profits, your account will grow, and it will grow exponentially if you continue to do so. There's no reason for you to be taking $100 wins and $500 losses day in and day out. That's roller coastering your account. Just stick to a set number and consistently grow. You'll see that this is very effective when you have that one trading strategy that you stick to. Again, all these three tips just intertwine. Now, this was a short video, but I hope you guys enjoyed it. These were my three tips to make you a better futures trader. And this is Victoria from TradePro Academy. I hope you guys like this video and subscribe. If you want to see more videos like this, just comment down below and let us know what topics you want to see. Now, I really want you guys to implement at least one of these little tricks and tips to your trading and see the improvement. You've got to be accountable for yourself and be diligent to become that full-time trader you want to be. Don't be one of the stragglers that just looks for the holy grail, looks to add more indicators, looks to add more size, looks to add more money into their account every time it drops. Just do these three simple things. Remember, stick to basics and you'll grow from there. Take care, everyone.